We are good. I'll upload it so everyone can see this after this is over.
Thanks, Ben. Okay. Let's see, Ben, do you mind sharing the PowerPoint?
There we go. Can everyone see it now? Or sharing it in the comments on this call.
Will you share your screen though?
Yeah, I'll share my. All right, here we go.
Perfect. Thanks.
All right, go for it.
Awesome. Okay, you can go to the next slide. First, we just want to say thank you so much. Our race is not possible without volunteers.
Yeah.
Absolutely not possible. So you guys being willing to come and help out. And if you're at aid stations, it's not always the easiest to get to. Some of you guys have crazy time shifts. So seriously, thank you so much for everything that you guys are doing. Go to the next slide. Awesome. So some of you guys are going to be helping with check-in packet pickup. So the scan code, if you are doing that, or if you're going to be around at all on Friday, the scan code will take you to the race manual. The past couple years, I've realized about 99% of racers' questions will come from this race manual. They either have forgotten them or they never read it. But Ben has done an incredible job over all the years to compile all those questions in there. So if you guys are helping with check-in, please, please, please take time to read through this manual. You are going to get questions when racers come up. And like I said, that will help alleviate you guys coming to me and asking the questions if you guys kind of are familiar with that race manual. Biggest thing that we changed last year at the check-in was that racers are not getting their bibs. So you are going to get that question a lot still. If they can pick up their bibs or if they can pick up a bib for a friend, they can't do that. They have to do it the morning of the race. We've had a lot of issues in the past where they pick up their bibs, we mark them as here, and then they never show up on race day. So then they count lost racer. So that's just way of when we have, we don't have a lot of cell service up there, you know, it's just a easier way to keep track of everyone. So please remind them that bibs are the morning of the race. So they don't want to show up 5 minutes before the race and they have to have their ID with them. So that's just a new policy that we kind of implemented last year and it seemed to work really well. And then the shuttle section in the racer manual, I would say that's probably 90% of the questions, shuttles. Ideally, we have everyone get shuttle tickets before the day of, but Nomadic Van has said that we can, that racers can get shuttle tickets the Friday. So if you have racers come up asking about the shuttle and shuttle tickets, they can buy the shuttle tickets. I believe Nomadic, at least one person from Nomadic Van will be there on Friday. So we can move the racers to them and they will handle all the money and shuttle tickets that way. As far as what to bring, definitely comfortable clothes. You'll be standing at the check-in almost the entire time. And then Ketchum is usually really, really, really hot. So please make sure that you remember that it's very hot, sunscreen, breathable clothes, and then snacks, drinks, anything that you'd like
there. Hey, Mary, can I say something there real fast?
Yeah, I'm done with that slide, so you're good.
Okay, so volunteers, Ketchum will be really hot. However, some spots like Cane Creek, early in the morning can be down in the 30s. Some of the overnight, depending on where you're at on the course, Ketchum is the low point of the race for the 100. The high point is 11,000. So that's a vertical mile. So be, you know, if you're working at one of those more remote spots, be prepared for mountain weather. Like Baptie Lake, sometimes it'll be a beautiful morning in the beautiful weather in the morning, and then it'll hail and have thunder in the afternoons and evenings as those afternoon thunderheads form. So just keep that in mind when you're out there. And I'm gonna go ahead and move to the next slide, unless anyone's got questions there.
Bug spray as well. There's more
Yeah.
mosquitoes this year than normal.
Yeah, very, very wet winter and spring. All right, go ahead.
Okay, so race morning. If you are helping with bib pickup, that could be from our aid station volunteers or you signed up for that. When you are getting to bib pickup, please allow time to drive really slowly on those roads. I feel like every year we have people get flats on flat tires because they're trying to race down that road. So allow at least like 30 minutes extra just to drive slow. And then if you did sign up for this one, it's pretty crucial that you show up. We've had a lot of volunteers not show up. I know it's a really early time in the morning, but we usually racers tend to wait until 20 minutes before the race to start checking in. So even though we say a whole hour, so we're really swamped trying to get them all checked in and get their bibs right before race time, and we want to start the race right on time. So if you did sign up for that or you are at an aid station and helping with that, please make sure that you show up early or you're there on time. And then, like I said on the last one, they have to present their ID. Pretty much any racer that goes, they're driving up there, so they should have their ID. So that should not be an issue. Last year, we only had one racer kind of have an issue, but her ID was in the car, so it was really just having her walk back to her car. So please, no exceptions. They really need to show their ID for that. And then be diligent with checking racers in, and we'll have those check-in sheets, but that's how we keep track of them all throughout the race. So just one mark could send us thinking that there's a racer missing out there. So if you're doing the race check-in, bib pickup, please be diligent with how you mark the sheet. Try not to be too sloppy so we can see your check marks and communicate that throughout all the aid stations. And then what to bring, where Ben kind of hit on this. In the morning, it's pretty cold until the sun rises. It's amazing when you're down in Ketchum and it's so hot, and then you go up there in the mountains and you're wearing like puffy jackets and hats in the morning. So until the sun rises, it's pretty cold. And so I would say to layer, especially if you're at Fall Creek, because Fall Creek is where that you kind of hit where the sun hasn't risen, and by the time the racers leave, the sun has. So layers are really great up there, comfortable shoes. If you are working Park Creek, definitely a headlamp. It's very dark when we're checking those racers in. We will have lights up there as well, but the extra lights would be helpful. And then a chair if you want to sit in. A lot of times it's easier to stand and get racers their things, but if you'd like to bring a chair to sit in, that would be awesome as well. Snacks, drinks. We won't have a whole lot of that at the bib pickups. So if you want to bring coffee, water.
Mary, at Park Creek, we will have coffee.
Oh, that's right. Your dad is going to do that,
Yeah, we
right?
will have coffee for y'all at Park Creek, 'cause I don't know about y'all, but I have to have my caffeine in the morning. Otherwise, it's a pretty bad day.
That's right. I forgot your dad. That's going to be an awesome
And
addition
I'll
to
have
that.
some dry creamer there as well for that, for those that need that for their palate. Anyway, I digress. Anyway, yeah.
Awesome. That was it. Anything else you want to add or any questions for that one? All right, then you're good to move on, Ben. All right, so the 30K, 60K finish line. This is where like all the fun happens. Again, please allow time to drive really slowly on this road. It's a long road. It's beautiful, but drive really slowly. In the morning, like I said, it can be very cold. In the afternoon, it can be very hot. So just make sure that you're wearing layers, and to bring a lot of energy up. This is where the racers are just spent. So when you are at the finish line and you're smiling and just have a ton of energy, it really goes a far way with our racers. So make sure that you bring your energy with them. And then what to bring, we kind of just hit that again, the lots of layers. If you're there in the evening, bring a headlamp. If you're there during the day, bring sunscreen and bug spray. There's not a ton of shade. We'll have shades with our tents, but otherwise there's not a lot of shade in a sense from the trees. So definitely bring sun gear if you have that, comfortable shoes, and then you can bring snacks and drinks. But at the finish line, we have Chef Jake is going to be there cooking hamburgers and have chips and drinks, and volunteers are welcome to that meal as well.
Yep.
So if you guys want to bring your own food, that's fine. If you want to snack on our food, that's great as well. Anything else to add, Ben? Any questions there?
Yeah, I have a quick question. I'm dropping off my husband for the 30K start and then working the 7 a.m. to noon shift at the finish line. How long does it take to get, I anticipate I'm going to be late, I'm hoping not too late, but how long does it take to get from the finish line? I don't trust Google Maps when I'm mapping.
Okay, so if you're going to drop him off at Fall Creek, is he doing the 60 or the 30?
The 30.
Okay, so to get from Fall Creek back to the other side where he's going to finish at, it takes about an hour.
Okay.
Yeah.
I'm trying to figure out something else, but I don't know if there's anybody else on here that's working the finish, but I will be there. It just might be a little bit late.
And I'm going to be, I'll be there as well. And there will already be an aid station there because of the 100.
Okay.
So, okay. Yeah. That's okay.
Yeah. Okay, and then as far as like finish line, I always just tell the volunteers to be super flexible with what we need. Sometimes it's helping with food, sometimes it's helping set up, timing, just different things like that. So just be flexible when you show up, and we'll place you wherever that need is when you come. Ben, do you want to go to the next one?
Yep.
All right, so the 100-mile finish line, again, with Ketchum, it's pretty much all the exact same. It can be cool in the evenings, not as cold in the mountains. It will be very hot since we will be down in Ketchum. So definitely bring layers. 100-mile, if you are volunteering, thank you, because those hours are pretty crazy. So if you are volunteering at the 100-mile finish line, we'll have coffee, we will have lots of different types of food, hamburgers, all that stuff. But we really appreciate that you guys are coming at pretty crazy hours. I think we have a shift from like
9 p.m. to 3 a.m.
Yeah. I have a newborn at home, so that doesn't seem so crazy anymore. But if you don't, I'm sure it's pretty crazy. So yeah. And then we definitely don't have as many racers coming through as the 30K and 60K. So the needs there for volunteering will probably be mainly cooking and taking care of each racer as they come in. We won't have Chef Jake is just going to be up at the 30 and 60K. So we'll be doing most of the cooking for them. And we'll have medical there as well. Again, sunscreen, bug spray. If you're coming in the evenings, a headlamp would be great, comfortable shoes. And of course, you guys can eat whatever food we have at the finish line for them as well. Any questions on the 100-mile?
I have something I want to say also real fast. So with all of the racers that are doing the 100, we are doing spot trackers on all of them. So like last year when I hosted the race, we had 23 runners, and we had 17 finish. And this year we have less. I'm hoping that it's going to grow over the next couple, 2, 3, 4 years. But we'll be able to keep tabs on those runners via the internet, and we'll be able to see when they're going to show up. That way, if like there's an opportunity for a volunteer to take an hour down and sleep a little bit, just be prepared for something like that. That'll make the nighttime portion there easier. That's all I wanted to add there.
Awesome.
Should we collect those spots? I'm sorry. So when the runners come through at the finish line, should we ensure that we have those?
Yep. Yeah, some of the runners have their own, but some of them we are renting from a company that's called, I want to say it's Track Leaders. I might be wrong. They're going to, we'll have a big, there'll be a web embed that we can watch so we can figure out where runners are at on the course. And that'll help make sure that we can be prepared for runners when they show up, and especially with this bigger race, that really makes things a lot simpler on us because we know when they're going to be at the finish line and at the different spots along the course.
Awesome. You can go ahead to the next slide. Common questions you will be asked. Shuttle schedule, that will be mainly Friday. We're going to have nomadic vans, at least one person there. So thankfully, we don't have to deal with the shuttle schedule questions. So when we figure out who will be there, I'll just let you know, and you can just basically point them. Before we kind of handled it, the finances and everything this year, they just completely took over all of that. So if you're asked a shuttle schedule question, just go ahead and direct it to Nomadic Vans. Where is my racer? If you are at the 30K and 60K, you're going to be asked that a lot, because a lot of people are used to being able to track their racer a lot more. And so the one thing I always tell people when they're at the finish line is whatever their friend, spouse, whoever it is, told them their time would be, add like 2 to 3 hours. and that's when, like, it's just such a hard race. It's such a hard race, especially if it's their first time and they say it's going to take X amount of hours, add 2 to 3 more before you come back and ask me about that. So that's my common go-to when they say that. And it usually ends up being around that. Can I pick up my bib, or pick up my friend's bib on Friday? No, there's no picking up friends' bibs anymore. We had that really big issue that one year where racers just didn't show up, and it was really hard to keep track. That's why you have to have the ID. You have to pick it up the morning of the race. And that's really a non-negotiable. If someone has an issue with it, just send them to Ben or myself. You don't have to deal with that. And then the required gear and gear checklist, we really highly recommend that they bring some type of jacket, just because of the weather. But the required gear, it's the food requirement. And that is something, Dan, if you want to speak on that, but the aid stations check that as they leave, that they have the required calories. So you can just kind of mention that the aid stations will be checking that. But they can grab stuff from the aid station. That can be part of what they bring out with them. And then what is at the aid stations? So our race supplies Tailwind and Honey Stinger, but as far as aid stations, they kind of get to choose what's at their station. They go shopping for it. So, pretty much, Dan, if you want to speak more on this, since you're the aid station captain, but, they know what racers like. So they're not going to just like have food that you don't normally eat at a race. So they'll have the typical waffles and jelly beans and things like that. But Dan, if you want to speak on that.
Yeah, we will have the staples. Every aid station will have things like pickles, water, Tailwind, other things like that. But then each aid station has flexibility to have specialty items. So some might have breakfast burritos. Depending on what information they give me ahead of time, we'll get that compiled. Like my aid station on the 100-mile has cowboy potatoes, which is tinfoil dinner, potatoes and bacon. Other ones have their own special things, but you can expect every aid station to have the staples a runner would want, especially for 30K, 60K. And for the 100-mile aid stations, there'll be more like hot meals and also things they can pick up and take with them to go. So you can sit down and eat, or you can grab something in a package and take it with you.
Yeah, awesome. So those are really the main questions that we get asked, specifically on Friday, sometimes in the morning on Saturday. Any questions there? Anything you want to add, Ben?
Yeah, in the volunteer manual, there is, for A Station captains, there is a menu list of things that are typically good to offer. Now, when it comes, now, A Station captains, if you're here, I don't see who's on this call currently, but keep in mind that what I used to do is I used to buy all of the race food, but the race has grown so much, I can't do that anymore. So I ask you guys to buy that food for the runners. This is for A Station captains. Typically, you try to stick to $2.50 a runner. So let's say you've got 100 runners coming through your aid station, like Cane Creek and Fall Creek. Well, you could spend like $250 on food if you wanted, and even more for for Surprise Valley and Bapti Lake. I will reimburse you, and if you want to email me, if you've got Venmo, that works really well. I can write checks. Don't leave race weekend without me having paid you for what you bought at the aid stations, and save those receipts as well and give those to me, because I the money is there. Everyone signed up for the race. There's currently have a little over 300 people signed up. That money is there, and I don't want to leave race weekend unless I've basically closed out the books on paying you your stipends and paying for the food that you're gonna buy. Okay.
Awesome.
Yeah.
You can go to the next slide.
All right.
Volunteer handbook. This is the last thing I believe on my slides. Go ahead and scan that. That's just our handbook that we would love for you guys to please read through before race weekend. And if you have any questions after reading through that, please feel free to shoot myself, Ben, Dan, an email, and we would love to answer that.
Yep.
And then I think you're good to go to the next one.
All right. So this is for me. And some of y'all, I saw David is on this call as well. We're going to be marking the course. I'm going to be packing everything up at my house next Monday. If any of you are available to help out on Monday, I know that's not part of this slide, but just let me know. Markers, they are on, I should have an example here, but I don't. They're just like little clothespins with, I do have an example right here when my kids was playing with it. If any of you can see on your screen, I've got this clothespin. It's got some tape tied to it. It's got reflective tape. All of them have them. All of the all those markers have that on them. If people that are sweeping the course, they should. What I do is I get some 550 core. I tie a big old loop of 550 core, and I just clip these on. And for sweeping, it makes it really, really easy. For people that are marking the course, I'll show you this next week. But I typically like to do a confidence marker, like every fifth of a mile along the race course, unless I feel like I need more. And I usually feel like I need more. So like these little clothespin markers, we've got 1,000 of them that I've made. And my mom, God bless her, and my daughters helped me with them. And then we have another 1,000 of the sprinkler flags that we can poke into the ground, and they have the race logo on them, which is awesome. So if you're helping sweep the course, get some 550 cord. It should be there at the aid stations unless it doesn't get put in with that stuff. In that case, just bring some string or a little piece of rope, clip them on and drop them at the aid stations. Sprinkler flags, sometimes I get them and they're all bent in half so they could be fit into a pack. Please try to avoid doing that, because I try to save them for you know, multiple years. You know, these, you know, the little clothespin markers, they take, you know, the burden time on each one of those is about 1 minute. So when we have 1,000, that's 1,000 minutes of a lot of work. So just try to be careful with them and try not to lose them. Just, you know, drop them at the aid stations, people that are helping with that. And that helps me out a ton, because I have to clean up everything else, reorganize everything once I bring all the race supplies back to my house in Nampa. So any questions or other things you want to know there?
Ben, did you also perhaps make some signs like wrong way, turn?
Oh, here, yes. Guys? Thank you for the reminder. Yes, I do have those. I have signs that say, they have an arrow that says go left or go right. And some of them have the race logo and it says Standard Hope Ultra Challenge. There's some wrong way signs. We have caution tape. Runners blow through them. It's very normal. Runners will blow through those signs and completely miss them. And there's nothing we can do about that. Let me think what else. We have signs at the trailhead, so we put up that say, hey, don't pull the trail markers down, please. Because, you know, that's been an issue in the past. People pull the race markers down, and that gets runners off track. If you can, get the CalTopo when you're helping mark. Get the CalTopo app for your phone and download the... you know, find the race course. Sorry, I'm getting all these calls. Download the race course onto your phone. That way you can look at it if you need a handy reference out there on the trail, because, you know, these cell phones with the race map, it'll pick it up. These pick up satellite GPS, and that helps me stay on course when I'm marking.
I had a quick question on one of the segments, Fall yeah. Creek to Broad Canyon. When you say Broad Canyon, do you mean where the trail comes down? There's a campground there near the road.
Yep.
Is that the
yeah, end that's of the segment? That's what I'm talking about there.
Yeah. Okay. And did you have a plan in mind as far as transport to either the beginning or the end of a segment?
Yeah, I'm trying to remember that. That's going to be part of next week, but that's not going to, yeah, we'll make sure that people are getting picked up and dropped off at the right spot out there. And that's been normal when we go out and we mark the course, but that's never been an issue. I want to be out there helping. We got a good crew of people helping with that. And, you know, shuttling cars is a big part of that. So, I have to, what day is that? You remember?
That's Wednesday for the Fall Creek, but we're planning on camping up to whatever segment we're going to be marking. And so we would just need a lift to either the beginning or the end of the segment.
Right. Let me take a look at let's talk about that after this brief. We can get that figured out. I was looking at it earlier today, and that shouldn't be I think that's going to work well. I can help with that, okay?
Yeah. And what time do you need help on Monday?
On Monday at my house in Nampa, 9 a.m.
And you're thinking you'll be up in Haley, what, early afternoon?
No, I want to try to get some lunch first at home, and then I'm gonna head up. It's gonna take me 3 hours from here. So I don't know. I'm guessing 3 or 4 p.m. I can't check into my room until I think 3 or 4. So, yeah.
Okay.
But I do plan to start loading up that trailer at 9. So if you want to help me with that, that'd be fantastic. Okay. Other questions on trail cleanup, markings, sweeps? All right, I want to move on. All right, communications. Do we have?
Do we have communications here? I'm pretty confident he's doing his own meeting tonight, so I think we can skip his slide.
Okay, I am actually going to speak on this a little bit. So This goes for everyone. Just to double down on what comms are doing, we have Starlink. It's being brought up from what's that city? Salt Lake. Get those, if you're everyone at the aid station, I would just recommend get the Starlink app for your phone, and take a look at this schedule for shuttling those units around. We should have 4 units available for the race, which is going to help a ton. So we can keep track of runners online as well, which is what we want to do. So take a look at that internet rotation. Those units do need to be transported in the middle of the race so we can keep adequate high-speed internet out there on the course, especially as the 100 moves around. So to take a look at that. I'm not gonna stay on this super long, but we have high-speed internet through Starlink. If you got some pictures, video, feel free to share those with us so we can get those up on social media while the race is happening. Questions? All right, medical. Jenny, are you on this call or she?
I am on this call. Hello, guys. Hey. Unfortunately, we only have probably 2 or 3 medical volunteers at this point, and none of them is on the call. So, I think it's a small enough group, and a few are local, that I could probably just talk to them. But if any of the non-medical volunteers on here know of anybody that could help, RNs, EMTs, paramedics, physical therapists, anyone in healthcare, we are a little short. So
I'm a nurse.
Oh.
I have my kids with me, and so I'm only working the finish line, but if you need finish line help, I can do stuff.
And when you say finish line, do you mean the 30, 60K or the 100?
Yeah, the 30, 60K. Okay.
Well, that actually would be helpful, because I'm going to be at the 100-mile start-finish, but I don't think we have anyone medical at 30-60, so...
I should also add, I work in administration at this point, but I do have my RN license.
Okay. I mean, from what I understand, and, you know, Ben and Mary and everyone else who's done this a lot longer can speak to it, I don't think there's major medical issues, and then obviously if anything is beyond anyone's scope, it would have to, you know, go through me in the hospital probably anyways. So,
okay.
But yeah, if you're available, that would be super.
Okay. If you want to let me know if I need to do anything new or specific. I won't be at the volunteer lunch, but I'll be at the check-in the Friday night. I'll be there on Friday.
Okay.
I think I have to look at the things again. I won't be there at the volunteer lunch, though. Maybe it's Thursday.
Oh, good. Yeah, I'll be there. Okay. When does the 30K start and finish? Remind me, guys. Sorry.
30K, 100 mile starts Friday night at 6. The 60K starts the next morning at 6 a.m. at Park Creek. And the 30K starts at Fall Creek Trailhead at 8:30 a.m. July 29th.
Okay. Okay. Well, yeah, so I can read the slides, but since there's no one on here, it probably will just...
Yeah, no, you're good. and then hopefully they show up on Friday, but you can always share those slides with your volunteers if you want as well.
Yes.
Ben, I believe that was the last part to our slides.
Okay. One thing I wanted to say, for medical volunteers, for anyone at the aid stations, if someone is at your aid station and they seem like they're in really bad shape, you can act like the race director right there and say, hey, I'm not feeling confident that your decision to move on to the next aid station is a good decision, because some of the stretches between these aid stations, especially when we get into all the hiking areas, it is a long time in between like good help. Like if someone gets in serious trouble, I had someone show up at the finish line. They were last place 1 year and they were borderline heat stroke. And, that was a really scary situation. Luckily I had, you know, communications going, but, that was, you know, feel for, you know, say, all right, you got to stop here, because you're not in good shape. And ultra runners especially will, I am one, you know, we will push ourselves to some really really extreme limits because that's just what we do. And we want runners to go home at the end of the day happy. We don't want anyone to have major medical issues. That's not a good time for anyone. So just keep that in mind when you're out there. Assess the situations that you see, okay?
Well, and I just piggyback on that. I can talk people through pretty much anything on a phone these days. So just FYI, I'm always available.
Okay. Thank you. I'm going to move on to the next slide. Okay.
I think the next three are medical.
All right. If you want to. So you guys can read these, especially if you're doing medical help. And I'm going to move on to the next slide. And that's it, isn't it?
Yeah, I think that's it. So that's it for our slideshow. Are there any other questions before we kind of wrap up?
Are these the supplies you need, or is there like a first aid kit at each aid station?
There are basic first aid kits, I think, at each station, and then some supplies here and there. I have to talk to everybody else about this, but I'm trying to get some more stuff. But if you have anything, or if you ever carry your own kit, I mean, it's always helpful to bring that kind of stuff.
Okay.
I do have a question regarding parking. I'm the one of the parking aides or parking what have yous. I don't know. Do I need a title? I help with parking. And I'm looking at the map here. And we were there last year. So I've at least kind of gotten acquainted where the start for the 30K is. And we're going to be like camping real close there in Fall Creek. Okay. Am I correct that the cars need to be west side, not crossing the bridge there in the creek to the campground or the trailhead, correct?
I can answer that. And by the way, thanks for helping with parking. I have a stop sign for you, and I have a cool vest that says race official. So this is
Is it brightly colored?
Yeah, it's brighter than my shirt here. So
fantastic.
Yeah.
Yes.
So this is on, let me talk about this because there are over 200 people signed up with the 30K. However, I will say this, last year we had about 50 of them that didn't even show up to the start line, you know, and the shorter races there, a lot of people will flake out. So I'm kind of hoping for that. Because if I actually do have 200 people signed up, that's going to be, let's just pretend that's not going to happen. So, this is who can park at Fall Creek Trailhead. Volunteers can bring the stuff that they're going to camp in there. That's not a big deal. People that are crewing, people doing the 100, they can park at Fall Creek. People that are crewing, people that are doing the 60K can park at Fall Creek. That already is going to be a lot of traffic for that trailhead. And if you guys have, anyone who here has been to Fall Creek Trailhead knows that our race day is the busiest day that trailhead ever sees all year long. The 30K, I was like, we're not going to park the 30K there anymore because that just doesn't work well. Runners, this is what I want runners doing the 30K to do. I want them to park on the main Wild Creek Road. So what people can do, which I'm okay with, people can drive down Wild Horse Road, which is road number 135. They can drive down to where the trailhead road splits off to the left, and it'll be easy to see. It's just the short little spur that goes into the trailhead, and they can't drive down that road, but they can flip around there. Once they flip around, drop their runner off, they can drive back up the road, park on the east side of Wild Horse Road, which is road 135. And they can parallel park on that road as far north as they want. All right.
Okay, so we want to keep them all on the east side, parallel parking, essentially facing out towards, as if, okay, hey,
facing north.
Oriented to then go to the finish line.
Yep.
Correct?
That's correct.
Okay. And then in which case, I'm kind of thinking maybe posting up right at that Y, so as people are coming in to be able to like, hey, are you, if you're 60 and a hundo, you can keep going, but if you're 30, you can drop your runner, turn around, and then you need to park here. Does that make sense to you? And
yeah, that does make sense. Should I have signs for the cars that are doing the 60 and the 100?
Signs, you say?
Yeah, signs that we can give the runners at runner check-in. Would that be a good idea?
Yeah. It could be. Well, they have a...
they won't have anything.
And the 30Ks are getting their bibs there at the start, correct?
Yeah, but like everyone that's done the 60 and the 100, I can maybe make some parking passes for them.
Yeah, it might help.
That'd be awesome.
Okay, that they can just put in the dash.
Yeah.
I will do that.
He doesn't have to talk to every single car.
Yeah. And all this.
Okay, that would be awesome. And then, Ben, for whatever it's worth, I know you've put a ton into this as well as everybody. I mean, but don't stress too much. I don't mind being the bad guy. So if all 200 show up, I'll take that for you. I'll take a little bit of stress out of you. I don't mind people not liking me.
Well, thank you. I appreciate that. Yeah, so far, so you guys know, so far race planning, especially having Mary and Dan to help with this, and Jenny, oh my goodness, having all of you, putting this together, this has funded my band. So you guys know what this race has done. It has funded my band program. Unfortunately, the school I just left, they decided they didn't need a band program anymore. They just cut it. But that's another story for another day. It funds my friend Pat Herb's band program. He's the band director of Wood River High School. Funds the charity for one of my wife's charities, the ARPKD-CHF Alliance. We give some money to the community school because they help with that aid station up in Surprise Valley. We've helped the local ham radio club there. I mean, we've done a lot with this. My friend Ava Hale, who teaches band in Buell, she's doing the aid station at Fall Creek. So I'm very passionate about music education and supporting the arts, and this race has helped significantly with that. So the amount of prep that goes into this, I love doing it, and y'all helping with this, it's seriously, it is, I can't thank you all enough. It means a great deal to me and my students and a lot of students across the state. So yeah, if you want to be the bad guy there, yeah, that's fine. Thank you.
Yeah, and then one thing, just checking as well, like I do plan, I feel bad to steal thunder after that very heartfelt, you know, thank you, everybody. I do want to see my wife off for the 30K, but I imagine most of the parking will be done. But I'm thinking of bringing a bike so my kiddo and I can like bust it up to the start when she takes off to grab a video, and then we'll get back in place. And then
what I'm actually thinking I'm going to do with the 30K, so everyone's on board. I haven't said this, but I want to start the 30K right there at the road when it splits off from Wild Horse Road, so that they have a quarter mile before they get to the trailhead and then get on the trail, because there's so many people. And that's going to be a better start line shoot
back
than what I've done.
Because you did the out and back before, so. Okay.
Yeah, cool. That out and back's not going to work. But yeah, we'll start it there. That way you're right there. And I'll be right there.
Cool.
Ben, we have one more question.
Ben, do I understand you to say you're not a band director anymore?
Oh, I'm teaching band in Baker City. It's a $23,000 pay raise for me, so I'm going to be teaching across the border next year. I just couldn't make the bills work in Meridian anymore. I wasn't making enough money with inflation, unfortunately. So, no, I'm very much, I'm not quitting that. I love teaching. Tess, you had a question?
Yep. So our whole family is coming to volunteer on Sunday at the Ernest Hemingway School.
Sweet.
So we'll come there and just meet up with you, and then do whatever there's
packing,
you know,
up
load or
a lot of that. Park in the parking lot there, and that's not a big issue, and that'll help me a ton. So yeah.
Okay. Cool. Good deal. cool. Do we have any other questions? I just got a warning that we have 10 minutes left before it shuts us off.
If you send me your address and an email, I'll see if I can get over there Monday morning.
Okay. We'll do that, David. Thank you.
Awesome. Well, if we don't have any other questions, thanks for showing up. You guys are more than welcome to still show up Friday. If you guys are going to show up Friday, fill out the lunch so we can provide lunch for you guys. If we don't see you guys on Friday, though, just find one of us, whoever, wherever you are, and we'll have your volunteer shirts that we usually give out on Friday. So just try to find one of us and we'll give those to you. But otherwise, I'm going to be down in Ketchum the whole weekend. Ben's going to be up in the mountains and then down in the Ketchum. Dan is going to be at an aid station, so we may or may not see you guys, but thank you so much for your help. We really, really appreciate it. Awesome. Thanks, guys.
All right, y'all have a pleasant evening. Thank you again. That was excellent. That was excellent. All right, ending this call.